In this video, we are going to test our secured Movies API project with JVT bearer token authentication from the Postman. Let's take an action. First of all, we are going to modify our launch settings for the multiple startup projects. So I am going to right click the solution, properties, and set the multiple startup project. We can start with the both of the application, Identity Server and the Movies API. Apply and OK. OK, after that we can run our application. You can click the Start button. Okay, once we start our application, we are going to get information that our server is up and running, and we can check our discovery document now. As you can see that the identity server is running in memory configuration, and we can check the our discovery document, and you can also see that our API comes in the Swagger GUI. Okay. So open the Postman collection, what we are going to build in the previous sections. Go to in here, and we have Movies API and Identity Server. Under the Identity Server, we have Get Discovery document, right? So we can check the by sending request in this URL. We are using the 5005 port for the Identity Server, and this is the OpenID configuration URL, which consumes the discovery document, and as you can see that discovery document getting response properly, so our service is working fine. So after that, let's check the our Movies API and Get Movies. It was working and we have tested Get Movies before, but this time let's see what happened. I'm sending request to the API Movies Get method, and you can see that 401 unauthorized response. So as we expected, it is not allowed to get a movies record without a token. So let's try now to retrieve a token from our authorization server with a Postman request. So this is our identity server, authorization server. We have a get token request. The HTTP method is post, and the URL is the connect and token. You can see the URL token URL from the discovery document. As you can see, the token endpoint is this one. We use this one for getting token from the identity server. So let me check the body again. As you can see that we provide some of the parameters in here. These parameters comes from the identity server config class. So let me send a request and get a token. Yes, we can get a token. Okay, now we have a access token, and we can use this token in order to reach the protected Movies API with get request. So we are going to set this access token into the authorization parameter of get request. Let me copy this token. You can copy this access token and go to the get movies request again from the Movies API collection. So this time we are putting the authorization. So you can set the bearer token authentication and give the token what you have taken from the identity server. Now send a request and let's see what happened. As you can see that this time we can get a successful result. We can reach the actual data our Movies API project. So also you can check the our identity server console output. As you can see that identity server output giving the information about the token endpoints, and we can see here is that our API send a request to the our discovery document endpoint and to retrieve a public key from the identity server to validate our token, and we can validate that this communication. We can see the communication between our API and the identity server is working properly. So once we sending request to Movies API with the token, it is validated from the identity server. These logs represent this action. So after that, we acquire a valid token again and send request to our API for the post operations. So this time I'm going to adding a new request and we will see the open the Postman again. And once we are sending the request to the GetMovies, we can manage to get result from the Movies API with the JWTB token. So we can also try with the post method operation in order to create a new movie. So for that purpose, I am open the post movie HTTP request in my collection. So we have already defining a new movie information. I'm changing the ID information. We need to increase one ID information. So after that, let me try first and see what happened. So again, we have unauthorized exception. So this time also, I'm going to adding the bearer token and remove the pasting bearer token in here and send again. Yes, success. And let me verify that in here. Send again. And if we see the 10 ID number, yes, we saw the 10 ID number movie object in here. As you can see that we can successfully test our get and post operations on our protected movie API project with using the JWTB token generated from the identity server.